In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear friends, warm greetings from the Carmelite Fathers, and welcome to Carmel Light, reflection on the day's gospel. It's Tuesday of the 33rd week in ordinary time. Today is the United Nations Child Rights Day. It's also the Universal Children's Day. We keep all the children in our prayers today, and we listen to the gospel reading from Luke chapter 19 verses 1 to 10. At that time, Jesus entered Jericho and was passing through. And there was a man named Zacchaeus. He was a chief tax collector and rich. And he sought to see who Jesus was, but could not on account of the crowd, because he was small of stature. So he ran on ahead and climbed up into a sycamore tree to see him, for he was to pass that way. And when Jesus came to the place, he looked up and said to him, "Zacchaeus, make haste and come down, for I must stay at your house today." So he made haste and came down and received him joyfully. And when they saw it, they all murmured, "He has gone in to be the guest of a man who is a sinner." And Zacchaeus stood and said to the Lord, "Behold, Lord, the half of my goods I give to the poor, and if I have defrauded anyone of anything, I restore it fourfold." And Jesus said to him, "Today, salvation has come to this house, since he also is a son of Abraham. For the Son of Man came to seek and to save the lost." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Let me begin this reflection with a simple question. What is the meaning of Zacchaeus? Anyone knows the meaning of Zacchaeus? My dear friends, you will be surprised to know the meaning. The name Zacchaeus means clean and pure. Got it? Zacchaeus means clean and pure. What a paradox. What is the paradox? This man, Zacchaeus, in the gospel, was living completely the opposite values, which never gave an impression that he was either clean or pure. You see, names suggest clean and pure, but the life is exact the opposite. Am I faithful to my name? We are all Christians. We have a beautiful name, Christian. Am I living exact opposite to Christian values like Zacchaeus? Zacchaeus was living exact opposite to his name because he was a tax collector. Adding to that, he had the highest rank in this money-making job. He was on the top. It is said he was the superintendent of customs and a chief tax gatherer at Jericho. This prestigious job made him a rich man, but physically and morally, he was small in stature. He attracted feelings of hatred and rejection from his own people. Having a prestigious job, he would encounter a multitude of people, and through them he had heard about Jesus healing a blind man in Jericho, which was his town. Now he is desirous of seeing Jesus. Let us consider three points. First, desire. As we have already seen, Zacchaeus was a public sinner according to the Jewish customs and traditions. The beauty of Zacchaeus is that he desired for something higher, to see Jesus. Second, effort. To be successful, desire alone is not enough. One needs to put efforts. Tax collectors knew how to collect the taxes in spite of people trying to evade them. That is a skill. He uses this skill to get what he needed. When he wanted to see Jesus, though he was small in stature, he finds the means to achieve it. He fulfills his desire of seeing Jesus by climbing a tree. Zacchaeus knew the worth of seeing the Lord. He made best use of the one and only opportunity he was given. What are the first 2 points? Desire, effort, and now the final point, conversion. Conversion. Zacchaeus' desire and efforts were not the fruits of curiosity, but born out of faith. Zacchaeus came down when commanded by the Lord, hosted a meal at the request of the Messiah, and decided to repay those whom he had harmed through injustice. This was because his conscience was made pure by the Lord. Zacchaeus is now, by name and by life, truly clean and pure. Zacchaeus is now, by name and by life, truly clean and pure. What about us? What about us? Let us pray. Today, as we find in the Bible diary, my dear friends, Adrian D'Souza from Perampalli, Udupi, Agnes Krasta Narampadi, Kasurgod, Peter Brian Menezes, and Benedicta Pinto Kupepada of Israel are celebrating their birthdays. As we thank God for the gift of their life, we pray God's choicest blessings on them. Derek and Sherlyn Siquera from Bengaluru, and Philip and Philomena Neri from Kemmannu, Udupi, are celebrating their wedding day today. Congratulations, my dear friends, and we pray God's abundant blessings on your family. We also remember all our personal intentions, all the children in the world. We in a special way pray for all our benefactors, well-wishers, donors of Bible diary. Sponsors of seminarians and all those who have sent their prayer requests. Dear Lord, help me to be clean and pure in my word and deed. Amen. Have a wonderful day, my dear friends. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I am Father Stephen Pereira, Carmelite priest. If you are interested to receive this audio directly from our hand on the previous night, and if you don't receive them in time, kindly WhatsApp your full name and place. My number is 94812-63229. 94812-63229. See you tomorrow, my dear friends. Have a great day. Bye-bye.